One, I'm going to be playing you some of my favourite tracks. The first one up, Depeche Mode, Walking on My Shoes. I haven't got too much to say about this one, to be honest about it, but it was probably the most influential song for me over the last few years. It has definitely guided my last album and the one I'm working on now, more than any other song has ever done that. You get vague ideas from songs, an idea for chorus, an idea for whatever it might be, a little groove or something, but this completely shaped an entire mood of album. Brilliant. This was actually doing the rounds when I was out on tour at one point, and I was with someone that was fairly important to me, and then it all went horribly wrong, so that the song kind of says it all. Most people have got stories about, you know, a woman messing about or a bloke messing about if you're a girl, whatever, and I think this has to be the best song ever for getting those feelings across and making you feel real bad, actually. I'm VH1 and I'm Gary Newman. Next up is Frankie Goes to Hollywood and Rage Hard. I guess most people pick Relax, which I love as well, but I always thought Rage Hard was just completely brilliant and special. And didn't really get that. It quite overshadowed, I guess, by Relax in many ways. I met him once. I did one of these Virgin inaugural flights up to New York and back when all that started, and he was on it as well. Excellent man, good laugh. But that's the only time I've met him, so I haven't got much to say about him. But I hope he's all right. But down. I met Roger Taylor from Queen years ago doing a round table thing on Radio 1, and he was a good bloke. And then many years later, oh hang on, I'll tell you something else first, actually. When I was a kid, I went to see Queen, where was it, the Rainbow, all went around backstage afterwards to try to get an autograph, and I invited fans in, and was signing stuff up in the dressing room, which I thought was the most brilliant thing. No one else I ever went to see did that, and I learned from that. And so now when I'm doing my stuff, I always sign everything, because I thought that was such a cool thing to do. But anyway, where was I? I was in Japan once. I was meant to be doing something with the band Japan, but they got fed up with me. So I ended up on my own floating around in Tokyo and went to see Queen at the Budokan. That's where it was. Bought a ticket, went in the front. Crowd went a bit funny. Got taken around the back to get out of the way and so on. And got to meet them. Well, they took me out that night. And they took me to a sushi bar thing, you know, where you sit on the floor and eat fish, which I hated. So I said to Freddie Mercury, I said, I don't want to be awkward or anything, and I don't want to be funny, but I don't like this stuff. And he said, you know, like, think nothing of it, lovey. And he sent off a limo to go and get me at McDonald's from up the road, and paid off at the restaurant manager to let me sit on the floor eating McDonald's, which I just thought was brilliant. They were the nicest people I've ever met, Queen. And I liked Freddie a lot, and it's a real shame what happened. And I find it sad, actually.
You. Okay. This is